Hi everybody, welcome to another how-to video with Codaster and Salomeka. And today I want to present a parametric analysis and how we can do a parametric analysis when we have only to modify and to deal with changes in the command file of Codaster. And that is why, because if you want to do a parametric analysis with modifying the geometry, it is more complex. You have to set up the whole pipeline, so we're not going to cover this. And this was one of the requests from one of our friends to show something like this, and we're going to do it based on the previous example that I showed a couple of weeks ago, where I considered a cross-laminated timber panel, and the idea would be to do a parametric analysis where we rotate the orientation of the layers of all the layers of the panel, and we observe the displacements that we get from this parametric analysis. I want to today. I'm just going to use Python to do everything, and also to run Codaster from the terminal. So everything will be based on this without using the Salomeka interface. I have here the folder of the composite example that I said before. So if you have completed this example, you can work directly from there. Going, and I want to do everything from zero. So I'm just going to create a new folder that I'm going to call parametric. And in this folder, I will copy three files that I want: the command file, the export, and the med file from the previous example. And okay, so the first thing that I want to show to start with, let's say, is modifying this file to take out the second panel, because in the previous example we had the two panels. One was the CLT panel, and the other was a panel with an equivalent homogeneous material that we used for verification. So now we want to take it out, and we just want to use the first panel without modifying the med file. So the med file has everything inside, and we have to specify that we want only panel A. So in order to do that, we have to do some modifications. One of these modifications is in the model. We have to tell him that we are interested only in panel A. And then we have to delete everything and modify appropriately. So this would be like this. This second material, we don't need it. As well, this other composite. We also don't need this. We don't need the reference to panel B. And this should be pretty much. And the other modification, I'm just going to use the displacements. I will not do any extraction of forces and so on. This could be a good exercise for you afterwards. So I'm just going to have the displacements from one analysis. Okay, and let's say that this is the initial file, and let's do a quick test to see if it runs. So I'm just going to activate Salome Cell. I have Salome on my path. Otherwise, if you don't have it, you can go to the folder and run Salome Cell command, or from inside the Salomeka. And now I can have us run. Sorry, I have to go to parametric. Okay, and I can go us run export. And let's see before what is the export file that we copied. We have the command file, a reference to the med file, the rmed that we want to create, the message, and I'm just going to delete the database. I don't want to create a database that I can restart the analysis. So being on this folder, we're just going to invoke Codaster, and we have an error. Okay, let's see. So we go to the message file, and we see that something is missing in Unite, so our modification there was not very good. Okay, so we're missing a comma. Should be like this. Okay, and this will create the result. So now we know that this file, okay, we see here the result. We know that this file is okay, and we can start our actual let's say parametric study. I'm going to save it as RankCase2. So we have two references. So let's start first to set up how many cases we have to run. We want to rotate the panel a total of 90 degrees, and we start from 0. We can say 0, 10, 20, 30, up to 90. So this is 10 cases. And I'm going to define an orientation list, I'm going to call it, that will give me this these angles from 0 to 90. I can do it like this. It can be done in various various ways, but let's say that this is one way. And I have this orientation list. The second thing that I have to do is to identify what which of these commands are constant, they're not going to change, and which of these commands are going to change. So I'm going to modify something definitely here in the composite command. The orientation. If when I modify this, I will have to modify also this, so the material assignment. The support and the load will not change, will be always the same, so I can move them up after good. Okay. And we can say that we will have to deal with these three commands. So what we're going to do is that we're going to do 10 analyses, 10 independent analyses, where every time we modify the material in this case. And after we do this, we're going to create a new result that will take the 10 independent results and we'll put them in a single result with the time, the instant from 0 to 9. So in the end, we're going to create a single resu file, single ArcMed file, so that it is easier to see the results. And the way we're going to do that, we need first to create the empty lists. So the way I am doing at least is creating some lists of the names. Okay. So here I'm going to call this component I, but before I do this, okay, not. Okay, so I'm doing a for loop. I'm doing for loop from 0 to 9, and when you see this for Codaster is going to create this. For example, if I is equal to 0, is going to create this, would be equivalently writing this, for example, or it's one, it's like this. So this is the way how we can do for loops and have a different command that is grouped, however. Because you have to know that if I am using something like this, for example, that every time I'm going to use the same variable, this is going to give me an error. Unless I use detruire, that is a command to destroy the variable. So if I just want to use the same variable that doesn't change, I have to destroy it at the end of the for loop. For example, here I would write something like detruire possible, something like the norm of the concept, and so on. But in this case, I'm just going to use comp I. Okay, and I make sure that here, this one. Then I'm going to use the material. I'm just going to change this to mat I, because also we have we cannot have more than 8 characters. So have to be careful to have short names. And here I'm going to use res I. Now the other thing is that here where we don't have specified the orientation, this implicitly is 0. So we have some layers with zero orientation, some layers with 90 degrees. Now we have to add for every loop, let's say that I have an angle variable that is taken from my orientation list. And basically this angle will be the angle of the main, the first, the third, and the fifth layers. I'm going to have here angle, while in the other two, I just have to add the angle. And here, since the orientation goes from minus 90 to 90, these are the limits, I'm going to start from minus 90. So in the final step, this will be 90 degrees, the principal layers, and the secondary layers will be 0. Now, once we have this, we have created the 10 result files, and this could be okay. I could have here multiple results in the imp resu and have an armed file with 10 results, but then it will be kind of more difficult to see the results. So I think that is important also to show how we can create a new result from so that we don't end up with 10 result files, but with one result, not 10 result concepts, but with one result concept. And in order to do that, I'm just going to create some new fields, some new lists I'm going to need. This I'm going to call it disp. This I'm going to call it affair. And I'm going to do another loop. And the first command that we're going is to use is createAmp. CreateAmp is create a field. It's a very powerful command. It has a lot of possibilities because it depends also on the type of the command, the operation that you use. In this case, we're going to say that we want to extract and we want to put it in the displacement list. We want to create a field and we have to give him the type of this field is type noeu Depth R. This will depend on the fields that you are creating. The name of the field that we are interested is the displacement, so depth. We have then to say where are we going to take, what is the result of this field, and this will be res I. And then we have to tell him in which instant from this result. When you don't specify an instant in MechaStatic, you always end up with the instant equal to zero. So basically now we're saying that for each result that we did, extract the displacement and put it in this variable. Once we have this, we have to do the crea-resu command. So let's say that we want to create a new result file. And here we have to give him a model. So we're going to maybe not. We have to tell him in which, what operation we want. Sorry. Okay. So here, as I said before, this is a command that has different operations. So we have here also to tell him what kind of operation we are using. So this is an extraction operation. Okay. Whereas where we are in crea-resu, we have to tell him that this is an operation affe. We are putting together a field. We have to tell him what type of result we are giving to him. And everything that is MechaStatic will be evol elas. We have to tell him which type of field we're going to give him, and in this case will be double. Then we have to give him the list of fields that we're giving him. So this list will be a list of 10 entries, as I started initialized it here. And this, I'm going actually to define it here, that is easier to deal with. So this will be underscore F. And we will have to tell him what is the model of this field. So model is the model that defined here. If there is a car-ILM involved, we have also to specify it. So element prop. And then what are the fields that we have? So here we have to make a reference to the displacement fields that we extracted. And finally, we're going to tell him in what instant we want to put this. And this here, I'm just going to use I. So in the end, I'm going to have a result that will be from 0 to 9. And just to say that you can also do this with other fields, so you can extract other fields. If you come here, you have a crea champ, for example, in res I, you enrich this field with the forces, for example, the generalized forces. You can do the same procedure, so you can write here more crea champ. For example, it will not be anymore Noeu Deplar, it will be something else, the type. And then you can have the same crea-resu with reuse and enrich the result. would be a good exercise for you to do. And having done that, we should be okay to test if everything is gonna be okay. So we are in the export. I'm just going to say that this is two. Let's say we want to have a message two and a result two. And hopefully everything will be okay. Not, we're going to take care of everything. So we have the new export. Okay, and now it is running the analysis, and you can see here raise underscore one, the second, the third analysis, and you can see here it is making references to mat underscore three, for example, four. And the time is always zero, we said. 7, 8, 9. So everything went well. I'm just going to show in the message file. This was the crea-resu command. So you see here that crea-resu that we wrote has this affair list where there are the list of the fields that we created. And so to finish, we can go to Paravis and import this result file. Parametric result 2 and generate vectors. I want to see also the deform shape. So I have a displacement of 1.3 millimeters in the first orientation, and as I am increasing, I'm rotating the panel, the displacement is increasing. And the final value is 11 millimeters. From 1.3 millimeters goes to 11 millimeters. So this is how you have now a single ARMED file with all your results of the parametric analysis. And I think this can be a good guide if you want to do your parametric analysis, to see how you can do it with CodaStair. This is one way, at least. There can be also other ways. There can be also some workarounds. I mean, this depends on the imagination, the creativity of anybody. But this, let's say, that is a general, can be a general way to do what you want. So I hope that this was something interesting, and I see you next time. Thanks for watching.